Greetings, Eric Bakker. Thanks for coming back. We're talking about Pseudomonas aeruginosa. We're talking about this particular type of bacteria and its effect on the human body. So let's look at some of the signs and symptoms. So as previously mentioned in another video, this bacteria is commonly found in the environment, but it's also found in the human body and on the human body. And especially in someone who's weak or sick or unwell, it can cause a big problem. So if we look at the bacteria, it can get into the bloodstream and make you quite sick, you know, causing bacteremia, or if it gets in deeper, it can cause sepsis, like a serious blood infection. We normally get those in a hospital setting, but anybody can get a blood kind of based infection. You know, you'll be looking at symptoms like fevers and chills and, you know, not feeling well at all and wanting to rest up. Pseudomonas can also infect the lungs very commonly, and it's also a common cause of pneumonia for many people. So pneumonia can be bacterial or viral. So a bacterial case of pneumonia can cause, again, fever, chills, you know, shortness of breath, all kinds of complications, can't sleep properly, many different problems, cough with or without sputum. And these are all symptoms, potentially, of a Pseudomonas infection. This bacteria can also affect the ears of people, causing swimmer's ears. So it can cause, you know, a discharge from the ear, or a lot of itching, redness, sounds in the ears, a lot of problems with the ears. It can affect the eyes as well. Eyes can be affected, you know, causing swelling or redness there, visual disturbances, many kinds of problems. So this bug can affect many different parts of the body, but I commonly see it in a stool test in immunocompromised people as well. Not people who are ready for hospital yet, but people who have got sicknesses like rheumatoid arthritis, psoriasis. I see it in people like that. We'll talk about that a bit later on. So those are some of the common signs and symptoms. But in my opinion, Pseudomonas is part of the bacteria pool that could contribute towards autoimmunity. And that could create a whole bunch of different type of symptoms and presentations depending on the autoimmune disease. Thanks for tuning in.